Good morning, Michael. Today has a high of 32 degrees and a chance of snow showers. Have a good day.
While it certainly does not happen every day and definitely still trying to get in the groove, the first thing that I like to do when I get up is to, of course, check emails and do some more admin type tasks. Now for email, I use Readle's Spark Mail app. I've used it the past couple of years and it's really developed and I just love the interface. I've tried some other email clients and I know it's incredibly subjective, but I like that this one has red receipts on the beta version. It's got some really cool organizational and team type features. This is also usually when I handle any top level business type stuff. I use QuickBooks Self-Employed to pretty much keep track of everything. Anyone that I work with can tell you that they probably get incredibly annoyed for how often I am changing apps. But lately I've been drawn back to Asana because I don't know, there's just something about it that I really like the design. And by far my favorite feature in Asana recently is their timeline view, which is just incredibly helpful and easy to see all the latest projects and videos that I'm trying to work on. Now, of course, a huge part of any laptop or electronic is the physical connection to the computer. In this case, it's the keyboard. Now, it's no secret that the butterfly switches have had their fair share of complaints over the past 5 years or so. And so with Apple switching back to the scissor switches, I can say after a month that I've had no problems with the keyboard, nothing sticking, nothing feeling off, and certainly nothing breaking. So that's a bonus in a premium computer. Personally, have always loved the chiclet style, shorter travel on Apple keyboards. I've used mechanical keys in the past with different various lengths of travel and different clickiness and all that sort of stuff. And I mean, you can get used to whatever you want to get used to. But for me, I really love the feeling of this keyboard. I feel like it allows me to type as fast as my fingers are capable of typing, and it's just really comfortable for long script writing or outline writing sessions. Now, if you're the type of person that really is doing the majority of these more simplified tasks, then you are really going to benefit from the battery life in this computer. I mean, if I'm starting the day at 100% and this is the first kind of series of tasks that I'm getting done, honestly, it can take anywhere from literally 0%, still showing 100% battery remaining, or usually around 97, 98. This battery is seriously efficient, and I think you'll just keep seeing that as this video goes on. So I'm actually kind of obsessed with keeping a minimal amount of files stored on my computer. Not only just for the aesthetic look, but also because most of the computers that I get have the minimal amount of internal storage, and with Apple, it's usually very, very minimal. And most of us don't have hours to sift through what all is taking up the most space. Why is our computer slowing down all of a sudden? Do I have any sort of security threats, malware, viruses, what have you? And for all those reasons is why I'm super excited for today's sponsor, which is a software I have genuinely loved for years and years. We're talking about CleanMyMacX. So seriously, I've used this app for years, multiple times a week, running smart scans, which is kind of the default feature of this, where you basically start it up, hit start scan, it's gonna empty your trash, it's gonna clear out your cache. No, I'm not starting a rhyming thing. It's also going to speed up your RAM, as well as it does an overview of a security check just to make sure there's no big viruses, malware, or anything downloaded behind your back. Some of the other most notable features I use that I am obsessed with in this software, though, is going to be the space lens. This you can use for any of your hard drives, whether they're internal or external. And I use it all the time on my Drobo here because I'm going through about 50 terabytes of storage that I constantly have to clean out and make sure is as optimized as possible, since every couple days I'm adding hundreds of more gigs for these videos. And so Space Lens allows you to very quickly see what is taking up the most space in what folder, and allows you to kind of all add them to its own secure trash bin, so you can get rid of it very quickly and get that space back either on your computer or external hard drives. Also, under maintenance, you're going to find something called free purgeable space. For the past couple of years, I've had issues with iCloud not fully deleting. It basically keeps it as like a cache. And so you'll notice you'll go through and clean up your computer, delete possibly hundreds of gigs worth of stuff, and you'll see that you gained no more space back. Well, free purgeable space basically goes in and corrects all of these errors and gives you that much needed space back instantly. Now, MacPaw, the creators of Clean My Mac X, are running a holiday sale until December 29th, where you can get 30% off all of their software, including Clean My Mac X. And of course, that information and links will be in the description below. Huge thanks to MacPaw for sponsoring this video, and let's get back to the MacBook Pro. Now, as soon as the family gets up, this thing pretty much stops becoming a business machine, and now it's just a child entertainment system. Although fair to say, not just for the children, but I find entertainment in it as well. So normally while they're up and my son is eating breakfast, hopefully the Mac Pro is rendering some sort of video project in the background, and that's where this becomes his good old television. But eventually, once he decides to let me use the laptop again and give it back to me, then I will usually jump into YouTube, check out some videos from my latest favorite creators. Now, speaking of leisurely activities, I personally like to casually game here and there, and so I was curious about what my options were on a M1 machine, being it kind of a new device. Well, I'm happy to say they have my favorite. That's right, they have Mac Chess. Kidding, I don't know how to play chess. So maybe you just got done binging Queen's Gambit and you fancy yourself a game. Who am I to judge? Of course, you can dive into the Apple App Store and they have their new arcade section, which more and more games are being optimized for the M1. Now, these aren't gonna be your Call of Duty AAA title games that you always hear about online in the gaming community, but there are some really fun time wasters, logic games, and some really beautiful graphics, I must say, for the developers who have created games specifically for the Mac system. But personally, I'm a fan of the more kind of basically any game that I can just like hop in really quick, blow some stuff up and blow off some steam and go back to work. Now, to achieve that, I've always boot camped my Macs. My Mac Pro is boot camped with Windows 10 on there, so I can hop into whatever I want. And I was curious, I know that boot camp doesn't work on here, but right before I was finishing up this video, I actually learned that Parallels came out with an update that allowed for Windows 10 to be installed on here. Don't get too excited, because as you dive further and further into the whole installation and setup process, you realize that you have to download a basically beta version of Parallels. So it's a little bit buggy. But then you can't install regular, you know, 64-bit Windows on the x86 or whatever it's called platforms. You have to download their ARM version of Windows, since that's what's compatible with these sort of processors. And so I got all the way to the point where I downloaded Steam. I downloaded, GTA 5 wouldn't even download. Technically, I got GTA San Andreas or one of the GTAs to download, as well as Drift 3. But sadly, they wouldn't even launch due to system incompatibilities. And so if you are a person who for work or for pleasure rely on a dual boot system with both Mac and Windows, I would hold off on the whole M1 systems for maybe a year. But let's get back to the pros of this computer here. For entertainment purposes, you have a gorgeous display. Of course, this is nothing too crazy new. It's typical Apple Retina display. It's got a decent 500 nit brightness that's going to do just fine in any indoor situation. not fare too well in direct sunlight. Of course, the display is P3 wide color, which is 25% more than sRGB. The speakers are also solid. Now, the past couple generations of 13-inch MacBooks, I've been always pretty impressed by the performance of them. They're not going to, you know, completely blow you away. If you are an audiophile, of course, you're still going to probably have some nice headphones to pair with it. But for the casual movie going experience, it's got a very nice stereo system and it gets decently loud. Now, again, jumping back to the battery here, this one will vary depending on what you're doing. If I would have gotten something like GTA 5 to run on this thing, obviously that is going to chew through battery way faster than just watching a movie. Now, some of these quarantine days where it's been pretty rough, we've watched a lot of movies on this thing, and I can tell you that almost a whole day of just having movies playing in the background still only uses like 50% of the battery, I'd say. And I mean, that's seriously like this thing playing something for like 8 to 10 hours, which stays on par with their 20 hour of video playback that they're marketing. And when it comes to creative work, of course, most of the time I'm doing the heavy lifting on my desktop Mac Pro. But I actually did a video on this specific MacBook Pro a couple weeks ago, talking about how it could be a pretty decent companion to the desktop and actually performs quite well doing some heavier tasks. Of course, you can check out that video in the card above. What I've noticed definitely while playing around with this in programs like Final Cut and DaVinci Resolve is the fact that your biggest issue isn't even performance, it's screen real estate. Professional video editing software has a lot of features and a lot of buttons and a lot of different screens. And when you compress that all into a 13-inch monitor, it gets pretty rough. Now, of course, yes, you can plug this into a secondary monitor if this was your main machine. But if you're like me and was hopeful of just traveling around with something on a much smaller size and give you the portability that, of course, a desktop isn't going to be able to, well, you may run into some issues. Final Cut isn't too bad because, of course, it's Apple designed and they're such a huge fan of minimalism, and they hide a lot of the more advanced features kind of in the different sub menu systems and whatnot. So you get a little bit more real estate towards your timeline, your viewer, and your main media pools. And in Resolve, honestly, the edit page was borderline unusable. I mean, if you have even a remotely complex timeline going, you're gonna be scrolling so much with the trackpad just to move a little bit here and there on the timeline. It's definitely way more worth it to go on the cut page where it dedicates most of the screen real estate to the timeline. You actually get a mini timeline overview of your entire timeline, which I absolutely love. And then of course your viewer is still quite small, but at least it's there and you can see what you're doing. Personally, my recommendation is if you're looking for something that is going to be your main editing machine and you don't plan on plugging this in to a larger secondary monitor, you may want to wait for the 16-inch because those extra 3 inches is going to make a big difference. Now, if you're into photography work, I did actually download the most recent Adobe Photoshop beta, which is M1 optimized. And well, you can see by this screenshot how well that went. I did eventually get it to boot up a little bit, but as plenty of other people are talking about on Twitter, it's borderline. I mean, it's pretty bad. I mean, it is beta, but it's like iOS 7 beta. Personally, if you're working on thumbnails, doing Photoshop type work, I highly recommend downloading something like Affinity. It is in the App Store under the M1 optimized kind of app section there. So you know that it's going to be incredibly efficient and be able to work with all the features and benefits the M1 machines offer. If you're doing like Lightroom equivalent work where you're just messing around with exposure and colors, I'm super pumped because Darkroom, which has been my favorite iOS app for editing photos, has now come natively to the Mac, and that is in the same M1 optimized section as well. Now, of course, for battery, this completely depends on how long you're doing a creative session and what software you are running, because something like Final Cut's going to be more efficient and optimized than Resolve, even though Resolve is M1 optimized as well. I mean, this could take your whole battery, but for me, generally, on the laptop, I'm only dedicating maybe like an hour or so, maybe a little bit more, a little bit less to do creative work. And it would take anywhere from 15 to 30-ish%. And for me, that's really freaking good. Pro apps are notorious for, you know, if you're working on a video, within an hour, your entire computer is dead. Even when I was doing the heaviest, working on pretty complex projects in DaVinci Resolve, as well as a thumbnail in Affinity, even that was like 40 or 50% for like an hour or two. And so, like I said, everyone's creative flow is a little different, so it's hard to tell you exactly what you're going to experience, but I can safely say that it's a much better and longer lasting battery experience than any other Mac laptop I've used. Now, I couldn't talk about creative workflows without talking about something that I see that everyone hates, and I don't know why, and that's the touch bar. For years, I have seen the touch bar catch so much flack, and in the beginning, I understood because it was constantly crashing on people. But now that it's working as well as any other part of the computer, I am in love with the touch bar. I get it, some people just like having a set dedicated amount of keys. They know exactly what does what, and they can always just, you know, muscle memory tap back at the top. But I loved jumping into every new program and just seeing what sort of different options I got at the top. A couple of the programs that I use more commonly, I started to really kind of memorize and know where they are, just like you learn anything else. And especially in the video editing programs where you don't have a lot of screen real estate, again, being able to scrub through your timeline very quickly without having to use the trackpad was incredibly helpful. And the fact that I even got a couple color grading tools on the color page in Resolve, that's just icing on the cake. Passionate rant aside, the 13-inch MacBook Pro is a fantastic first-generation product. From performance to battery life, you really start to get the sense of what Apple can do when they have complete control over the hardware and software. It's just incredible the efficiency that they've been able to pull out of this laptop. Is it perfect? Of course not. I know myself and every other creator out there is super excited for the release of these 16-inch versions or whatever they're coming out next year. However, for the price, the 13-inch is something that I can just really see myself using over and over and over.
Good morning, Michael. Today has a high of 32 degrees and a chance of snow showers. Have a good day.
Well, there you have it, guys. That is a day in the life of the 13-inch MacBook Pro M1. If you liked this video, got any value out of it, definitely hit that like button. It lets me know that you want to keep seeing videos like this. And don't forget to get subscribed for all the upcoming videos that we have going into the new year. Huge thanks to everyone over at MacPaw, the creators of Clean My Mac X, for sponsoring today's video. And remember, if you guys want to check out their different software and get 30% off, there's a couple days left in their sale going on right now. The link is in the description below. As always, thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next video.